Yeah, cue the dramatic thriller music. The harshest film critic in South Africa, JB Sebastian, joins us. Dun, dun, dun. He's supposed to give a threatening face.
A particular set of skills kind of thing.
Oh, I love it, I'm loving it. But before we chat to you about what's happening on the movie scene, let's quickly check out the top five at the box office.
This is the South African top five box office hits over the last weekend. The biblically inspired epic Exodus, Gods and Kings takes a dip this week and drops down to number five. Big Hero 6 keeps families entertained, but not quite enough to stay at the top and instead takes fourth spot. The sweetest bear of them all, Paddington, slips from number one to third place in its second week at the cinemas. The world's most famous fairy, Tinkerbell and the Neverbeast, fly straight up to number two. In a surprising turn, it's fantasy film Seventh Son that takes the number one spot in its first week of release.
Well, of those top five, JP had to say that Paddington is very cute, which makes me think like he's going soft. What's going on, bro? You gotta remain the harsh critic that you are. Yes, keep that face on. But right now we're talking about what you can expect opening at the cinema this coming weekend. And one thing that I'm very looking forward to is Taken 3.
Taken 3.
Come on, man.
Really? Say it again. Say it. And say it with the number. Pronounce it.
Taken 3. The third installment.
If there are three. Exactly how good at his job can this guy be?
You know, he's Liam Neeson, though. He can do anything.
The third time around, you still don't have your wits about you? You still having your family taken from you a third time?
Dude, when you got gangsters from Tropoia chasing you,
and when you've got
anything can happen.
Old age coming on, exactly. And you're forgetful, and you leave your daughter at the market or something like that.
So is this what's happening in this installment of the movie?
Weirdly enough, he insisted that with the creators, he'd only been it if no one is taken.
Wow.
So I don't know how that works out, but I do know, in fact, that, and you can give it away because you see it in the trailer. He's just noticed there, if you were paying attention, that he comes across his wife having been murdered. And he gets framed for it, he's set up for it. But at the same time, his previous employers, the FBI, the CIA, and
whoever he's employed
wherever by. He gets these skills from, including forgetfulness, they're pursuing him as well as him trying to pursue the people who, did this, who is tearing his family apart and still, again, trying to protect his daughter.
Now, looking forward to that one. What's up next? Pride, let's talk a bit about that.
Pride is a true story, in fact, about it's the gay and lesbian community of England during the Thatcher regime. Mm-hmm. So this was the time when she was really ruthless to the miners. And same time, the regime was highly homophobic and in fact had policy, actual written policy against that community. So them, it's the story about this small community trying to push their cause and to stay on the radar, but as well, out of just concern for their common man, notice that the plight of the miners as well. They take their efforts and raise money for the miners. So it's this clash of two sort of impossible worlds. If you take stereotypical gay person and stereotypical lesbian person, mix it with small, inland country people, and you have your stereotype of what country people like. Yes. You can call them close-minded and whatever. But these two worlds collide, and like I said, even in the true story, they work it out and both ended up supporting each other, and then it's quite moving actually, and it's getting a lot of rave reviews and maybe very relevant to South Africa. Fragmented causes coming together as
well. The story of hope, we all need that in the world, don't we?
Yeah, I think so. As grumpy as I might seem, I think that it's good that fractured causes, whether you're gay, whether you're straight, whether you're a minor, who knows,
Quickly, so something to look forward to this weekend, you'd say, yeah?
Absolutely, and obviously we're going to be talking a bit later.
Exactly, yes, Angelina Jolie's movie Unbroken, where JP will be giving his harshest criticism. Can't wait to hear that, so stay tuned for that. But right now, let's find out what else is coming up. Ilana.